Maurice Audin, 25, father of three, mathematician, communist, and committed to Algerian independence. His beliefs would make him a symbol of a system of torture by the French state during that struggle.
We went to bed. The children were all asleep, and during the night, there was a knock on the door. They'd come for my husband. They took him away, and then we never saw him again.
Paratroops arrested Audin and took him to the LBR detention center on June the 11th, 1957, where he was interrogated and allegedly tortured. Only a letter from another communist activist arrested a day later shed any light on Audin's treatment.
I saw Maurice. He was haggard, his face pale. He murmured to me, "It's hard, Henry."
Nearly 3 weeks later, Maurice's wife, Josette, was called in by soldiers.
They said they had a piece of good news to share with me. And that was that my husband had escaped, and they'd nothing more to say to me. I walked out of there in tears, saying they'd killed him.
Theories over Audin's fate swirled until 2014, when then-President François Hollande officially declared that he'd died in detention following an official visit to Algeria. Emmanuel Macron would go even further, pushed by two MPs, one a communist, another his own, who've long held an interest in the matter.
Maurice Audin was one of those who were the victims of a system. It's a moment where we can look at history head on, not to apportion blame without distinction, but invite people to talk and dress wounds.
Macron called Josette Audin after his election last year on the 60th anniversary of her husband's disappearance. He promised he'd do all he could, finally, to bring her the answers she'd been seeking for so long.